Hello everyone, welcome to the second part of complete denture discussion. Today I'll be discussing the short notes from the previously asked ProStoke question papers. So coming to the first question, that is, what is compensatory curves? For this you have to refer chapter 8 occlusion in Rangarajan, page number 148. Under this question you have to write what is compensatory curves and then the two types, that is the anteroposterior curve and the mediolateral curve, and then you have to explain which curve comes under the anteroposterior curve, that is the curve of Spee, and then mediolateral curve you have to write about the curve of Wilson, monsoon curve, anti-monsoon curve and Plesher curve. Next question is selection of posterior teeth for complete dentures. For this you have to refer chapter 9 page number 157. And in this, usually, and if they ask about anterior teeth, you have to write about the size, form and color. Whereas in posterior teeth, you have to mention only about the size and the form. So in size, you have to mention about the buccolingual width, mesiodistal width and occluso-gingival height. And under form, you have to write about the anatomic and non-anatomic form, teeth. So you have to write at least like 2 to 3 lines about each. Then next question is buccal shelf area. For this refer chapter 4 impressions and cast, page number 52. You have to write buccal shelf area is a supporting structure of mandible. Then you have to write about the boundaries of buccal shelf area and then 3 to 4 lines about it, and then diagram is a must. Role of saliva in complete denture. So this is a question which you have been answering since your second year of BDS. So you must be aware of the answer. So first you have to write what is saliva, what is the composition of saliva, what happens when salivary flow decreases, then what happens when the quality of the saliva with increase in age, and then how it affects the denture retention, then the flow of saliva can be influenced by which all medications, then classify the amount of saliva and also mention about the xerostomia. Differences between arcan and non-arcan articulators. So here I have enlisted 6 differences between arcan and non-arcan. So in arcan articulators, the condylar element is attached to the lower member, whereas the condylar guidance attached to the upper member. And then the condylar guidance pathway is a curved as well as straight, and Bennett movements can be produced, and it also allows condyle to move in a curved pathway during eccentric movement. An example is Whipmix articulator. Whereas in non-arcan, it is completely opposite. That is, the condylar element is attached to the upper member. Condylar guidance is attached to the lower member. And the condylar guidance pathway is only straight. And the Bennett movements can be produced in a straight line in a progressive manner. And it also allows condyle to move in a curved plane during eccentric movement. And then the example you have to give, that is the Hanau's model and the Geisei and dentatus. So the fifth point is actually the same for both arcan and non-arcan. Otherwise, it's all the other points are different, opposite. Then coming to Christensen phenomenon. For this, you have to refer chapter 6, maxillomandibular lesions, page number 103. First, you have to write, give an introduction on what is protrusion. And then you have to write what is Christensen phenomenon that is seen in natural dentition. And then how it should be in a complete denture. So, these 3 points should be written for Christensen's phenomenon. Then combination syndrome. Combination syndrome, refer chapter 16, page number 243. First, define what is a combination syndrome, then write the features, and then there is a flowchart given of a sequence. So you have to draw that flowchart and then write about the treatment planning for combination syndrome. Then real life effect. So for this, you have to refer chapter 13, page number 209. First, write why a occlusal harmony is needed, and then you have to write about the causes of occlusal discrepancy, and then write about the relief effect, and then how these occlusal discrepancies can be corrected. Mention it. Then what is modulus? So modulus is a muscle, that is a facial muscle, okay, and then it is located lateral and little superior to each angle of the mouth. and you have to mention about why it is important in prosto, why it is important for complete denture fabrication, and then which all muscles contribute to this modulus, all those you have to write, and then you have to mention about the motor supply as well as the blood supply for modulus. Then denture stomatitis. So for this, refer chapter 3, page number 24. Write what is denture stomatitis, then write the classification, then write the etiology, then diagnosis and the management. Then post-insertion instructions and complete denture treatment. For this, refer chapter 13, denture insertion, page number 212. So for the post-insertion instructions, there are main four headings. One is denture insertion and removal. Then second is what to expect from dentures and how to use dentures and care for dentures. So at least like 3 to 4 main lines you have to write for each heading. And then also mention about the recall and the maintenance. Then mucostatic impression theory, it was already discussed during the long essays and the short essays. So first mention about the three theories and then write about the mucostatic impression theory, like different names for mucostatic impression theory, who proposed, and write 2-3 lines about the technique and the disadvantages. Then posterior teeth form. So in the posterior teeth form, it's like it can be either anatomic and non-anatomic, and then modified anatomic teeth. So there are many examples they have given, mentioned in the textbook, for modified anatomic and the non-anatomic teeth. Minimum 3 types you have to write. Porosities in denture bases. So you have to write what is porosity, and then like it's most commonly seen in the acrylic denture base. And then there are 2 types of porosity, internal porosity and the external porosity. And then write 3 lines about internal porosity and external porosity. Then impression techniques and complete denture, I have already discussed it. You can refer chapter 4, page number 41. Now coming to next question, that is Bennett angle. For this, you have to refer chapter 6, maxillomandibular relation, page number 105. First, you have to write what is lateral excursion and then the 2 types of condyle seen during lateral excursion, that is the working as well as the non-working condyle. Then write 2 lines about non-working condyle and then mention about the Bennett angle and draw a diagram for this. Border molding. For this, refer chapter 4, page number 71. First, define what is border molding and then write the purpose for border molding and the 2 techniques. Then Gothic arch tracing. For this, refer chapter 6, page number 125. First, you have to write about the methods to record CR, who proposed it, then the concept, then the components, indication, contraindication, advantage and disadvantage. All these should be mentioned. Then age changes in edentulous patient. For this, you have to refer chapter 1, page number 3. And you have to write about the effect of aging on bone. In bone, you have to mention about the RRR, residual rich resorption. And then you have to mention about the effect of aging on oral mucosa, taste, saliva, mastication, deglutition, skin and nutrition. Then next question is relining and rebasing. For this, you have to refer chapter 15, refitting and repair, page number 227. First, define what is relining, then what is rebasing. Then you have to mention about the indication and the contraindication and the procedure. Mention the steps. So there are 3 main headings, that is static, functional and chair side. So all these things you have to mention. Then stability in complete denture. Refer chapter 4, impression and cast, page number 39. First define what is stability and then mention the 6 factors affecting stability. This is like occlusal plane, teeth arrangement, vertical height of residual ridge, etc. Like that, 6 factors are there. Mention all the 6 factors. Then mental attitude of edentulous patient. So for this, refer chapter 2, page number 11, So first you have to write the contents under the heading mental attitude, then mention the classification, and then write 3 to 4 lines about it. All the 4 classifications should be mentioned, that is the philosophical patient, exacting, indifferent, and historical patient. Then neutral zone. So for this, refer chapter 11, page number 185, and write all the contents under the heading tongue space. Also mention the causes and then draw the diagrams. Coming to the last question, that is the lateral thought form. For this, you have to refer chapter 2, diagnosis and treatment planning, page number 18. So first you have to write what is the lateral thought form. Then you have to mention about the Neil classification, that is the 3 types, that is deep, moderate, and shallow. And then you have to draw all the 3 diagrams for each. So that's all for today. Next time I'll be discussing the FPD questions. So thank you so much.